We're asked to determine an equation for a possible trig function from the table of values. So while it is possible to do this just by analyzing the table of values, I think it'll be helpful if we actually plot these points on the coordinate plane. So let's go ahead and do that. Here we have the point 0, 4, 2, negative 2, 4, negative 8, 6, negative 2, 8, 4, 10, negative 2, and 12, negative 8. So right away, based upon the behavior of these points, it should remind us of either the cosine function or sine function, meaning the behavior of these points resembles either the sine function, as we see here in blue, or the cosine function, as we see here in red. So if we connect these points so that it resembles either the cosine or sine function, it would look something like this. Whether we want to form an equation involving the sine function or the cosine function, we can actually use either one, but notice how if we start at the y-axis, notice how we have a maximum, and then it goes to the midline, a minimum, the midline, and then a maximum. So if we don't want to have a phase shift, we should recognize that this resembles the cosine function as we see here in red. So to come up with the equation for this function, we're going to focus on this piece of the graph. And now that we've decided to use the cosine function, our job is to find the value of a, b, c, and d for our function. So for a quick review, for both the sine and cosine function, the absolute value of a is equal to the amplitude. 2 pi divided by b is equal to the period of the function. The value of c affects the vertical translation, or shift up or down, and the value of d affects the horizontal shift or phase shift, which is a shift left or right. So if we go back to our function, let's start by identifying the midline. The midline will be halfway between the maximum and the minimum. And since from 4 to negative 8 is 12 units, and 12 divided by 2 is 6, our midline will be at y equals negative 2. So let's start by determining the value of a, the amplitude. Well, the amplitude is the distance from the midline to the maximum, or midline to the minimum. So the distance from negative 2 to positive 4 is equal to 6, therefore a is equal to positive 6. We know it's positive because this cosine function has not been reflected across the x-axis. Next, the value of b is affected by the period. We can see along the x-axis, after 8 units, the graph starts to repeat itself. So the period is 8 units, which means 2 pi divided by b must equal 8. So if we multiply both sides by b, we have 2 pi equals 8b. Divide both sides by 8, we have b equals pi over 4. So again, so far we know a equals 6, and b equals pi divided by 4. Well, the value of d affects the phase shift, or shift left or right, and this graph has not been shifted left or right. Therefore, d is equal to 0. And then finally, c affects the vertical shift up or down. And since our midline is at y equals negative 2, the graph has been shifted down 2 units. Therefore, c is equal to negative 2. And this is all we need to determine our cosine function for the table of values. Our function will be f of x equals 6 times cosine pi divided by 4. Again, since d is equal to 0, we just have times x and then minus 2. This would be a possible trig function based upon the table of values. In the next video, we'll take a look at the same problem, but we'll show how we can do it using the sine function. I hope you found this helpful.